so did the iBook guy. I have been asked repeatedly to look back at some of the older operating systems and determine if they're actually obsolete today. So I'm going to do a little mini-series on OS 10.4 Tiger, and then Leopard, and then actually Windows XP. And we're going to find out if they're truly obsolete. Now, it's important to note that this video is being produced in November of 2013, so keep that in perspective if you're watching this a few years from now. Now, in this first video, I'm going to be doing OS 10.4 Tiger. Now, keep in mind, Tiger was first released back in 2005, which was over 8 years ago. It was also made for PowerPC and Intel-based systems, but I'm going to be using this Intel-based Mac Mini for my testing. I had to come up with a set of criteria in order to judge these operating systems, so I decided to pick some of the most popular software applications and tasks and find out if they would work. I think without a doubt, having a modern web browser should be at the top of the list, so let's go straight to that. The web browser situation on Tiger is in a sad state of affairs. There are only three browsers that will really even work, and all three of those browsers are out of date and no longer maintained. Your choices are
Firefox 3.6.28, Safari 4.13, and Camino 2.12.
Camino is still the most up-to-date browser of the three available, and even it is a year and a half out of date and is no longer maintained. However, in all of the tests I performed, Camino was actually able to render every website perfectly. And there is one silver lining about web browsing on Tiger. Okay, I hate Adobe Flash, and I'm truly amazed that it's still in use today. Unfortunately, I must grudgingly admit that it is a crucial part of the modern web browsing experience, and it may be another few years before it goes away. So the good news is the last release of Flash for OS X Tiger was actually only 4 months ago, back in July of 2013, so it's still pretty much up to date and will run most anything perfectly fine. So if you're still running Tiger and you use a combination of Camino and the latest version of Flash, you can get by on the internet pretty well. In my testing, I was able to stream movies from Netflix and Hulu, play games on Facebook, and all the normal stuff that people do with pretty much no limitation. It might be a ticking time bomb, though. I have no idea how much longer that will continue as the browser and Flash become more and more obsolete. Okay, so what about iTunes? Well, the latest version that you can get from your Apple update is going to be iTunes 7, which is horrendously out of date. However, you can get iTunes 9.2.1 using the link provided here directly from Apple. Unfortunately, even that was made back in July 2010 and is several years out of date. It most likely is not going to operate any of your newer iPhones, iPads, iPods, or any of those types of things. So what about an Office suite? Microsoft Office 2008 is the latest version from Microsoft that will run on Tiger. Now, that's really not too out of date. After all, the company I work for, all of our Windows desktops are still running Office 2007, and we tend to get along just fine. However, if you like the free Office suite from openoffice.org, the very latest and newest version will still run on 10.4 Tiger with no problems. Okay, so what about iLife? Now, iLife is a suite of a whole bunch of different applications from Apple, and it includes all kinds of stuff like iDVD and iMovie and GarageBand, and the latest version of these things you can run on Tiger is iLife 08, which is several years old. Now, what that means to you is going to vary greatly on your needs. For some people, iLife 08 is probably going to be perfectly fine. Other people are going to require the features in some of the newer versions, and in which case it's going to be a problem. So what if you need some virtualization software? The only thing I was able to get running was VirtualBox 3.0.12, which was from November of 2009. However, I was able to get Windows XP running inside of it, and the irony about that is once I got XP running inside of VirtualBox, I was able to actually run a lot newer applications than what I could run natively on OS X Tiger, despite the fact that Windows XP came out back in 2001, which puts it at a 12-year-old operating system and seems to be more supported by modern applications. So it's important to have a good media player program. The newest thing I was able to get working was VLC Player 0.9.10, which is several years old. I think it's from July 2009. However, it was able to play pretty much everything I could throw at it without any problems. And as far as Skype goes, sorry guys, it's just out of the question. I couldn't get Skype working in any form or fashion whatsoever, so you might as well just forget running Skype on Tiger. Okay, so what about a photo editing program? If you like Photoshop, The last version you're going to be able to use is CS4, which is several years old. If you need something newer, you could probably run newer versions of GIMP, but I know, you know, it doesn't do all the same stuff as Photoshop. Now, if this were my only computer, I would have to be able to run a BitTorrent client. And unfortunately, this is a problem. The newest thing I could find was a version of Transmission that was several years old. And it actually works just fine on Tiger, but the problem is it doesn't support magnet links, which is what all the new torrent sites use. So downloading a BitTorrent is pretty much out of the question on Tiger, unless somebody can find a better BitTorrent program that's still compatible. Okay, so I think we can pretty much stop here. It's pretty obvious that Tiger is very obsolete. But I want to point out something. If you're using an Intel-based machine and you're running Tiger, it's automatically guaranteed that you'll be able to run either Leopard or Snow Leopard, assuming that you have enough memory. And so there's definitely an upgrade path for you there. And just moving up to Leopard, just the next operating system, opens up a slew of more modern programs that are going to run on your operating system. I would also like to point out in Tiger's defense, though, it's a good operating system. It's fast, it boots ridiculously fast, it has a very small memory footprint, and it's very stable. I'd probably still be using it today if it weren't for the lack of modern software supporting it. And, you know, I personally prefer speed and stability over all the new, you know, features of these operating systems that are coming out. And so I'd probably still be using Tiger if it were supported by all the modern software programs. Well, I hope you found the information useful, and I'll see you next time in the video about Leopard and Windows XP.